What is up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. For our first Gunpla review, we will be starting things off with the 144 scale Earth 3 Gundam. This is our main character's Gundam in the ongoing Rerai series. Now, let's open it up and see what we got. Inside the box, we have a total of 5 runners and 1 polycap sheet. This is runner A with all the multicolored parts and the clear part that we have here, which is the green one. Runner B1, which comprises of all the white parts. Runner C and runner D in color dark gray. And this is for the joints and most of the parts of the planetary system. PC-002, which is the polycap sheet that we use for the Gundam. The VMEPEC parts. This comes with the flat tip parts. A sheet of sticker, which has its eyes, the stickers for the camera lenses, for the planetary system, this is number 4. And also for the beam rifle and the shield connector. And also we have its manual. So let's put the guy on the table and see what we got. Out of the box, I love this kit. For a tiny Gundam, this sure beats most of the reasons out there. Now, let's see what we have for Core Gundam's accessories. So, first accessory that we have, it's tiny shield. Here we go. As you can see, the connector here is with this pop-up one. And this one is for the Core Gundam to hold it up. Let's put it on our base here. Next we have is a beam rifle, a short beam rifle. Let's put it there. We also have 2 adapters. One is this adapter, which has 2 3-millimeter pegs at the side. And we also have a flat one, which you can do for customization and use it for customization as well. So let's see it up close and let's see what we have here. Now let's go with the Core Gundam's articulations, starting off with the head. So with the head, it is connected by a polycap joint, as you can see there. It can do the side to side without any worries, as you can see. Up this much, down this much. Let's do the tilting up again. It has a rocking motion, which is really nice there. Full 360 without any worries. There you go. Let's go to the body. It has this gimmick of opening up here so we can add in the Earth 3 armor, but we're not gonna use that for now. This is a clear piece, as you can see here, and all the color separation here is looking really nice. No paint apps whatsoever. Arm is connected by a ball socket here. There you go. Bicep swivel without any worries. Double bend on the elbow looks really nice. There you go. One more time. Really nice. Hand is connected by a ball socket here. No other movements whatsoever. 360 is no problem. Hand connector is connected like this. Oops, sorry about the feet. Hand connector is connected like this, so don't force in the weapons of the Core Gundam or else this will pop off. There you go. No ab crunch, because it's connected here like this on this part. With regards to the backpack, it has both of the beam saber holders along with the beam saber hilts. It can point downwards, as you can see here, and also point upwards. There you go. It also has the booster, which tends to fall off if you force it too much, but just secure it there so it doesn't fall off. Let's go to the waist. So with the waist, the front skirts are connected together, but you can split it in half so that it moves independently. No side skirts, no back skirts. It can go as to this way, turning around, turning here, can do a 360. Legs is connected by a 3mm peg, as you can see here, to a polycap. Bicep swivel, no worries here. Double bended knee joint, as you can see here, here you go. Can fold us to this much, so it doesn't have any knees per se, but you can see that later in the Earth 3 conversion. So legs or ankles, I mean, is connected here by a two parts. There you go. This is connected again by a ball and socket, so it can do rotation just up to here because it's being hindered by the armor. If you force it just a bit, it can go all the way around, but I'm not suggesting that much. There you go. So you can see here, this is, I'm just going to put that on the side, this is the connector part when transforming it into the Earth 3. There you go. No worries at all. There you go. And that is it for the articulation of the core Gundam. Okay, so before we show you the planetary system, let's add all the accessories to the core Gundam so that you can see it up close. And let's start it out with its shield. So with the shield, as you can see, and I've shown you all this already, with the core Gundam, I mean, core Gundam can hold it up without any problems. Just slot it into its hands. You might want to fold this. This is used when it's being stored, so just slot it in there. There you go. So it can hold it up really nice without any problems. Even if I tap and tap, it doesn't let it go. It's really good. Then we have its beam rifle. Beam rifle, just slot in as always without any problems. Shake motion, nothing there, doesn't let go. But yeah, don't force it out too much, because when you force it, it actually disassemble in this end here. Okay, so don't force it too much or else it will pop off by itself. Okay, so I'm gonna pick it up later. Anything that falls, we'll just put it back together later. Now let's go to the back. Let's remove the shield here. At the back, we can just slot in, as I've said, there are two backpack connectors. So the two backpack connectors, as you can see here, one has two 3mm pegs, as you can see there, which can carry most of customization weapons or even sets of other accessories that you can buy. And also this one, you can slot this, as I've said just a while ago, with a shield. You can pop up this again and store it at its back without any problems. There you go. If you don't want the core Gundam to just hold the shield on its hands. Now for our beam sabers, core Gundam has two beam effect parts. It has this long one, which is primarily used when it is in the Earth 3 Gundam mode, and this tiny little dagger type. So the tiny little dagger type goes on to this, and same thing, it's just, since it's facing, it's a flat type, it can only face into one direction, or it's awkward when you put it on like this. See? You mostly put it like this, facing forward. Rocking motion. It doesn't want to let go of the saber as well. Good job. And but it tends to be a bit loose. It is easily removed with just one pull. So we can put it on the side as well. And let's go to the planetary system. And there you go. Now that is the planetary system for the core Gundam, which when combined it forms the Earth 3 Gundam. This one is the Earth planetary system, which is rocking a bright blue color, as you can see there. Let's put it on the core Gundam to see the Earth 3. And there you go. Now, when combined, it forms the Earth 3 Gundam along with an upgrade with its weapon and its accessories. Now, let's go to the Earth 3 Gundam and see what we got here. Now, we have the Earth 3 Gundam. Let's check its articulations. So, with the head, no problems with the side-to-side. As you can see there. Still has that rocking motion without any worries. Full rotation, not being hindered at all. New armor on the body, covered and tucked in with this part here on the top. Shoulders just slot in and stays in place without any worries. As you can see, even if I rock it out. Arm extension, cover for the hands, which looks really nice. With regards to its waist, we have new front skirts, just connected to its old front skirts here. Back skirt, which plugs into its behind here, as you can see. New backpack. Beam saber parts or beam saber holders are now pointing up. With the core Gundam only, it is pointing downwards. Extensions for the feet, which now holds its place without any worries. I thought I was putting it on wrong, but it was just me. Sorry about that. So if we disassemble this, it is connected here by this flat surface here, and then just connects there. Come on, there you go. Feet is now tucked behind, as you can see here. Very nice, there you go. Now let's go to the feet. So for the feet, we have it on a connector here, which makes it rotate all the way through. Feet is on a ball type socket, as you can see there, without any worries. It can go up to this, going back and then going forward. Up just to this. Let's test it up when it is standing. So going to the back, let's just remove this first. Here you go. Now feet planted on the ground. On the side can go up to here. By the way, the feet is still planted on the ground here, okay? So let's not go to the other side without any worries. Same thing. Going to the back. Just this much because it is being hindered by this part here. Going to the front. Okay, nice. There you go. Now let's go to the new accessories or the add-on to the accessories that the core Gundam has. So let's put this on the side here. There you go. Stay. Now for its beam rifle, it has been extended with this part here. Let's just remove this. As you can see, this is from the front part of the planetary system where it is being tucked. So we just plug it into the beam rifle of the core and there you go. Nice. Now for the shield, it has been extended as well with this part. There you go. So this is the old shield for the core Gundam alone. Now this came from the planetary system. We just slot it in using this pegs here. There you go. Now when we combine it with the core gun, I mean when we combine it with the Earth 3, the rifle and the shield, we can slot this part here. There you go. So it can hold its rifle here. We can slot this one, this peg here, onto the side of the arm, so you can see there, and let the Earth 3 hold the rifle. So let's put it on and see how it looks. And that is it for our review of the Earth 3 Gundam. What are your thoughts about this kit? Let me know down in the comment section down below. And don't forget to hit that like button, click on the subscribe, and turn on the notification bell for future reviews. Thank you so much guys for watching, and I'll see you on the next build. Peace.